I think we can go ahead and get started here. Again, good morning, good evening, and good afternoon, depending on where and when you are viewing this webinar. Thank you again for joining me in a quick walkthrough of the Standard Imaging Customer Portal. Again, my name is Craig Krause, and I am the Customer Care Director here at Standard Imaging. And I am excited to do a quick walkthrough because I think the Customer Portal is a fantastic resource for our customers. So, but before I get started, I wanted to head over and take care of some housekeeping. This webinar is being recorded, so if you need to step away or you want to share it with a colleague, which we definitely encourage you to do, we will be posting this to our website as well as sending an email with a link to the recording to anyone who is registered for the webinar. If you have questions while I'm going through the presentation, please enter them in the GoToMeeting dialog box, and I will try to answer them as they come in. If I don't see them for some reason, I will definitely make sure I follow up at the end of the presentation. So if you're not familiar with Standard Imaging already, we are based out of Middleton, Wisconsin, which is a small suburb just outside of the capital city of Madison, Wisconsin. Standard Imaging started with a modest product offering back in 1989, but over the past 30 plus years, we have developed and manufactured a full suite of radiation therapy solutions. So before I jump into and go through the customer portal, I want to talk about some of the requirements for signing up for an account for the customer portal. And that is, you do need to register with a valid company email address. This company email address then is connected to the actual company and the Standard Imaging assets or resources that you own are then connected to that company. So these connections are what allow you to view specific solutions in the customer portal, which again, we'll explore shortly. So why should you sign up for an account with the customer portal? And I think there's some really good reasons. Again, the first one is that it provides you access to our resource library, things such as tech notes, manuals, publications, videos, as well as much more. In addition, you can track your calibration status of the QA of your QA equipment. You can also view and download your calibration reports if we have those on file for you. You can also track your technical support service cases, as well as you can browse through our loyalty rewards and you know, basically take advantage of some really good deals. So without further ado, to register for an account with the customer portal, you would go to this website, standardimaging.com/customer/account/register. Alternatively, you can go directly to our webpage, standardimaging.com, which I'm going to go ahead and jump over to that right now. So when you go to our website, again, standardimaging.com, at the very top, you're going to see this sign-in option. So if you hit that sign-in option, if you don't have an account already, you would go ahead and hit request access. This will take you to the registration page where you would fill out, you know, very, very little information, really. Again, just your email address, create a password, your first and last name, as well as the company name. You'll go ahead and hit register. This then gets sent over to us. We review that. And then, again, as long as you are registering with a company email address that we can tie to a company, we'll go ahead and approve that account, and you'll get an email with confirmation. If you don't, for some reason, qualify, then we'll let you know with the email that you provide in this registration form. So I'm going to go ahead and jump back and sign in to the customer portal using my credentials here. So once I sign in, you can now see that instead of the sign-in option, I have the customer care portal button that I can go ahead and choose. And so what I'm going to do now That then takes me to into the customer portal. And the very first page that it's going to take you to is the software licenses. As you can see at the top here, this is where basically you are going to be able to browse to all the different resources within the customer portal. So again, the software licenses are the first thing that you're going to see. This is a great resource, you know, especially if you've had your software for a long time and you may have, maybe have misplaced the CD, the hard CD that came with your software, and so you lost maybe your license key. You can just browse in and you basically find that here. Additionally, you can review to see if you're current on your maintenance. As you can see in our test case here, in our test account, basically, both of our software products are expired. So if you do want to take advantage of our 24/7 support, as well as get the most current version of the software, what I'd recommend you do is just go ahead and click your renew option. That'll take you to this dialog box where you can basically fill out some information. Really just special instructions, hit request renewal. That will get sent directly to your regional account manager who will follow up with you and provide details on how you would get to current on your software maintenance. So I'm gonna jump over to the hardware tab. This is very similar to the software tab in that it will list all of your hardware that we have listed. It will also provide you your warranty dates, as well as, again, a renew option. So if you want to renew your warranty, which you can do for products that are 7 years or newer, you would hit the renew button, and very similar to the software renewal, it would basically send a contact information directly to your account manager, who would then follow up with you to renew your maintenance. One thing that is different here in the hardware tab is this view details option over here on the right. And basically what that is it provides you information about your calibration. In our test account, we don't currently have any calibrations. So I've actually contacted one of our partners, Campbell County Memorial Hospital. I'll shout out to them. They're located up in Gillette, Wyoming. They've actually given me permission to log into their account. So that's what I'm going to do here now. So again, I've switched browsers here just so that we can kind of view this Campbell County Memorial Hospital. And if I click on the view details button now, this actually gives me the option. It shows me both whatever calibrations that we would have for this, in this particular case, this A1SL chamber. It would show me the different calibrations that we have on file, and then you can go ahead and click this download report, and you can download a copy of the calibration report. So I'm not going to go ahead and do that now, but you get the idea of what you can do. So I'm just going to hit this go back to hardware option here, and the other thing I wanted to show you is you can see that this particular chamber, it looks like it is no longer it's no longer available to renew the warranty on it, which leads me then to the loyalty rewards section. So I'll go ahead and click on the loyalty rewards tab, and you'll notice here on the bottom that A1SL chamber is listed with a trade up option. And again, you can hit that trade up button. That will then take you to, again, this dialog box. You can fill out some information if you want to provide any special instructions. But again, this gets sent directly to your regional account manager, and then they'll follow up with you with any trade-in options that you have available as part of our loyalty rewards program. In addition, on the loyalty rewards page, you can see current promotions that we might have. So for example, if you have an electrometer that meets the life cycle age criteria, and if you kind of read the details here, it's basically any hardware equipment that is at least seven years or older, you would qualify for the life cycle age criteria, and you could certainly upgrade your hardware then. So in this case, you could purchase an electrometer and get a free X-ray and ion chamber, which is a great deal. Additionally, we have a promotion on our beam checkers. If you have a 7+ year old QA Beam Checker, which is our daily device, you qualify for a $1,000 discount off the list price automatically. So I definitely encourage you to continue to check out the loyalty rewards program and certainly contact your regional account manager, what you can do here for other specials as well. So that's the loyalty rewards tab. Next, we'll jump over to the support cases. And this is a great place for you to track any open cases or closed cases. So we'll provide you the subject, basically, of what you may have contacted our customer care team for. You'll also see the product serial number or what the question related to. As far as the status, so there's several statuses that could be here. For example, closed that you see, in progress. There could be, you know, if you send something in for service, there it might be at the calibration lab, or it might be in shipping, or it might be in service. But you know, for example, let's say you send in a chamber for calibration, and you need to make sure you need to get it back for doing your monthly QA. You send it in and you can track it here and make sure that it is on time and that you're going to get it back in time for you to do your monthly QA. So again, this is a great way for you to track, you know, anything, any support cases or any equipment you send in for service. So finally, we've got the, I'm going to jump over to the resource library. The resource library, again, is a great tool. When you first go here, it's basically going to show you all products and all content. But we provide this filter at the top. So just as an example, let's say I wanted to find a manual for one of our QA products, our Beam QA products. So you can see once I choose the Beam QA product, it then if there's additional options, I can then you know, choose between our QA Beam Checker Plus, again, that's our daily device, our QA Cross Checker, which is our monthly device, or our QA Stereo Checker, which is our, which is primarily used for CyberKnife machines. And as soon as I choose these different options, it automatically fills. So, so this, in this case, I'm showing all the publications on our QA Stereo Checker. But if you wanted a manual, you could certainly go do that option. Or let's say you are, you know, as an example, you're going to be doing a small field dosimetry, and you've heard that our X-Radon scintillators are a fantastic tool for that. Then you could certainly check that out. So you could very quickly go to our X-Radon detectors. Oops. Getting ahead of myself. Choose the W2 scintillator. And then choose either manuals, which, or I'm sorry, publications, which gives you great publications. And so again, you can go in and click on any one of those, and it'll actually take you directly to that publication. So it's, again, it's a great resource for you to get more information about not only products that you own, but maybe products that you're going to be looking to purchase. So we also have videos up here, as well as webinars and other resources that are available to you. So in short, I know it's a short webinar here, but that really kind of covers the customer portal. I think it's a great resource, and I would, if you haven't already signed up for an account, I would definitely recommend that you do so. You know, if you don't want to register yourself, you know, just send an email to support@standardimaging.com, and we can go ahead and create an account for you. And so, you know, we definitely want people to take advantage of the resources that are available here. So if you have any questions, please go ahead and post those, and I'll check to see if I've missed any here. So looks like I have a couple questions. So the first one here is, can you download software directly from the portal? So that's a really common question, and not at this time. The reason for that is because we need to make sure that when you want a software download, we need to check your account and make sure that we're getting you the correct version. So what I'd recommend in that case is that you would just go ahead and contact support at standardimaging.com or go to, directly to our website, fill out a contact form and request that. And then we would follow up with you and send you an email with a download link where you can download not only the installation instructions as well as the software. Okay, one more question here is, how long does it take to get your account approved? So usually within 24 hours, but if you need immediate access, again, I would definitely recommend just contacting support at standardimaging.com, and then we can make sure that we get you logged in right away, as soon as possible, basically. Okay, I'll wait maybe another minute or so to see if there's any additional questions. But in the meantime, Standard, as the customer care director, I just wanted to emphasize that we are here to help you. So if you ever have any questions or concerns, whether it's about the portal or anything else, I encourage you to contact us either at support@standardimaging.com. You can call us directly. We are based here in Middleton, Wisconsin. We almost always answer the phone, talk to a live person. So I definitely encourage you to contact us. We also on our website have a web chat option. So definitely, we have multiple ways that you can contact us. All right. Seeing no more questions, I just want to thank you for joining me today. I hope you take advantage and I look forward to talking to you here in the near future.